Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, Flowerpot men, Flowerpot men, Flowerpot men, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, Flowerpot men.
Once upon a time, there was a little house. All round the house was a beautiful garden. And down at the bottom of the garden was a place where the man who worked in the garden left his things while he went into the house to have his dinner. One day, when he'd gone into the house to have his dinner, he left behind a lot of things. A garden fork, two little flower pots, two middle-sized ones, and an old pair of bellows. He'd been mending them because he needed them for his kitchen fire. And of course, there were the two big flower pots as usual. And just behind the big flower pots was a little weed.
Weed? Weed?
And there they all were, lying quietly in the warm sunshine. The little weed looked all about her, and when she saw that everything was quiet, she knocked gently on one of the big flower pots.
Weed! Weed!
And out of the flower pot came a little flower pot man.
Oh!
He peeped out to see if anyone was there.
Oh.
And he thought he heard someone coming, so he popped down again.
Oh.
Then the little weed knocked gently on the other flower pot.
Weed! Oh, weed!
And out of the other flower pot came the other flower pot man.
Oh.
He peeped out to see if anyone was there.
Oh.
And he thought he heard someone coming, so he popped down again.
Ow.
After a while, they both came up together.
Oh.
Huh?
They leaned over their flower pots and said hello to each other.
Hello, Bip.
Hello, Bip.
Then they said hello to the little weed.
Hello, Bip, Weep. Weed?
Hello, Bip, Weep.
But instead of getting out, they began to dance and sing in their flower pots.
Bip, bip, bip.
Bip, bip, bip.
Bip, 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 bip.
Flop, pop, pop,
bip. Bip, bip,
bip. Bip, bip,
bip. Bip, 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 bip.
Flop, pop, pop, bip.
Little Weed thought it was quite time they got up and went out into the garden to play, so she called out.
Weed, weed, weed,
weed.
And the little flower pot men jumped out and looked for something to play with. And they saw the old pair of bellows the man had left lying on the ground. They couldn't think what they were, so they tried to find out. Now, the man used the bellows to blow up his fire when it was getting low. But Bill and Ben didn't know that. The one who was looking at the pointed end called out, "There's a little hole here."
Hip-hop, hip-hop, hip-hop.
Hip-hop, hop.
The other one at the other end of the bellows tried to lift the handles. And suddenly, one of the handles came up and hit him right on the chin. He tried again, and the bellows blew out a great puff of air. Right in the other flower pot man's face. They were most surprised and wanted to find out what it was all about. The flower pot man lifted the handle again. And this time, the bellows made such a funny noise that Bill and Ben started laughing.
Fuddle, poof.
Fuddle, poof.
And they thought that if they could find something else to make a different noise, it might sound like music, and they could play together just like a band. So one of them went to the shed to look for something that would make a noise, and the other one went on playing with the bellows. Then he heard a new kind of noise. And there was his friend coming back. And look what he'd found.
Hello.
A little tin of nails that made a sound like a rattle. And he had the end of a watering can, and he could blow it like a trumpet. Now, they were only thinking about how much they were enjoying themselves, and not at all about the poor old bellows. And they were very surprised indeed when the one on the bellows found himself tipped off.
Oh, tip.
And a huffy, puffy voice said,
"That's enough. You're making me tired with all that nonsense. I'm quite out of breath."
What a noddle. What a little teacot up.
Now I will show you what I can do without your help.
And the bellows began blowing and puffing at the flowerpot man.
Oh. Oh.
Oh. And blew him right away.
Oh.
Then the bellows started to look for the other one who had made such a noise and jumped on him with his great big boots. And he chased him round until he got caught in a corner. And he had to climb up the trellis to get away. Then the bellows turned round, panting and blowing in a puffy sort of voice. Just then, old Slowcoach came along, and he thought the bellows looked rather cross and grumpy. So he said in his slow, tortoisey voice,
"Is anything the matter?"
The bellows looked at him.
"They danced off me and made a noise."
"Who danced on you?"
"Two things that came out of those two flower pots."
Then Slowcoach laughed.
"They were only Bill and Ben."
And he began to sing Bill and Ben's song.
"Oh, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, Flowerpot Man."
Then, as he couldn't see Bill and Ben anywhere about, the bellows went back to the same place and lay down again. Now, all this time, the little weed had been watching. And she knew which of the flowerpot men had danced on the bellows and made it angry. You listen, because little weed is going to ask a question.
Was it Bill or was it Ben danced upon the bellows then? Which of those two flowerpot men? Was it Bill or was it Ben?
Was it Bill or was it Ben? It was Bill. It was Bill.
Heep. Hey, dial up. Heep, pip.
And when Ben came in, they both said hello to Slowcoach.
Hado, Slugalug.
Hado, Slugalug.
Hello. You'd both better say you're sorry to the bellows.
So they went over to the bellows to say they were very sorry. They really didn't mean to be unkind to him.
He did a little bit uncuddle. Bop.
And the bellows said,
that's all right.
Oh, Tala, Tala, buddy, muddle.
Oh, Tala, Tala.
When Bill and Ben found he wasn't cross anymore, they jumped up and down and started playing and dancing all over again. And this time, the bellows blew harder than ever. And even old Slowcoach joined in, singing in his cracked old voice. They would have gone on playing, but they heard the little weed calling.
Weed! Oh, weed!
Oh.
She was telling them that the man who worked in the garden had finished his dinner, and she heard him coming down the garden path. So they said goodbye to old Slowcoach.
Bawa, Slugalug. Goodbye.
Then they said goodbye to the bellows.
Bawa, Bepop.
Bawa, Bepop.
Goodbye.
They marched back, playing as they went. They jumped into their flower pots. And said goodbye to each other.
Bob-wop.
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 Then they said goodbye to the little weed.
Bob-wop, dip-wop, weep, weep.
Bob-wop, dip-wop, weep.
The little weed stayed behind the flower pots and went fast asleep. And there they all were, lying quietly in the warm sunshine. But the man who worked in the garden never knew that anything had happened at all. Nobody knew about the flowerpot men. Only you saw them playing. And the little weed. And I think the little house knew something about it. Don't you?
Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men. Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye.